Okay, you guys. It's simple supper tonight. Let's eat. Of extra napkins on the side, which you always need when you're eating ribs, right? Baby back ribs. And I always call it simple supper. Because it's stuff you can just whip up real quick for your family. Baked beans. Dakota's Pride. From the can, baked beans. They're pretty good. Never had them before, but they're all pretty good. Baby back ribs, signature Provence. You get a ton of sauce in there. The ribs are good. It's the sauce. I'm not crazy about the sauce, but it's just because I have my own preference for right now Wood Ranch barbecue sauce. But the ribs are really good. And corn on the cob, frozen corn on the cob from Vaughn's. Of course, my Texas toast. Frozen food section. Coleslaw from Smart and Final. And Jello for dessert. These little Jello cups. It has like lime, strawberry. There's three different flavors. And sometimes I like to have a paper plate when it's summer. It reminds me of like a barbecue or a fun outdoor picnic. And of course, my go-to non-fat milk. I always like having milk because it reminds me of growing up as a kid. We always had milk for every single meal. Just a little etiquette note for us ladies out there. Do you know? I don't know how I knew this. It wasn't like something my parents told me. But before I got married, I would never eat ribs and corn on the cob on a date or like out in public because it's so unladylike. And that was just me. And I would eat fried chicken if it was a drumstick. I'd pick it up with one hand, kind of eat the end. I would do that. But I never talked about it, never said anything. And you know what's kind of funny? I've never really said anything. Like growing up to the girls as they were growing up. But do you know I have one daughter who feels and acts the exact same way about ribs and corn on the cob in front of guys or in public. And the other daughter could care less. And the funny part is, the one daughter that's more like me, she's concerned about it, and the one that's more like my husband, she doesn't care. I just think it's kind of funny how people are the way they are. And it doesn't really matter. As a older adult, it really just makes you look at life and just wonder more about things like, how are people the way they are? Why are people the way they are? Because some things are just unexplained. But anyways, here's something that is explained. I'm talking about manners. You know, we had this family ritual. My dad was home. Again, he was a, for those of you new to the channel, my dad and my uncle, both retired airline captains from Flying Tiger Airline before they merged with, or either merged with FedEx or FedEx bought them out decades ago. But they'd be home for a week and they'd be gone for a week. They'd be home for a week, gone. Which was nice, because we had, like, when Dad was home, we'd have formal supper. When Dad was gone, we'd have fun kid supper. So when Dad was home, always at the big kid family kitchen table. Oops. I almost forgot my phone. Pepper. So, Mom would set the table, and my one sister would always be, like, around Mom during supper, preparing for supper. She'd help with the napkins and the silverware. She always got my dad a toothpick. It was like this little ritual that he would always sit down to his meal and he'd have a toothpick on his napkin waiting for him after the meal. It was such a big deal. Between her and my dad. Okay, so we always had to wash up before supper. We always sat down. We waited for everybody. And the funny part was, my mom never ate supper with us. She would sit down and be with us at the table, but she never ate. And we would talk. We'd laugh about it. She says, "I nibble so much on everything I'm cooking that I'm not even hungry when it comes time to eat." It's kind of funny, but so we'd always say our prayers before meal, and I don't think anybody led the prayer. I think we just did it. It was the same prayer every single meal because we were brought up Catholic. It's kind of funny to look back at that. And so then we'd eat. Never forget my sister, always a fancy eater. Sometimes my brother, but my dad so many times would say, "You need to finish what's on your plate because they're starving children in China." That was a real thing, and they didn't laugh or make a joke about it. I really said that. The whole time when my dad would say that, I'd have a picture of this cartoon of these cartoon characters that used to be with a shovel digging a hole. Maybe it was Bugs Bunny or the Roadrunner, and there'd always be a comment. There'd always be a comment about reaching China or the starving kids in China. And as a kid, hearing my dad say that, I would think, is that a real thing? Or did he Like, what came first? Did he say it and it's a true thing, or he saw it from the cartoon and it's a cartoon thing? I'm serious, I would really think hard on that. Crazy. And then we could never, when we were done, we could never just get up and leave the table. We had to say to Dad, "May I be excused, please?" And we never had to, like, bring our dishes to the counter or anything like that. You know, we didn't have to place napkins on our laps. And there were little things we had to do, but not a huge big deal. And then, we always had to be polite and eat with our mouths closed. Both my mom and my dad would get after us if we were, you know, eating mouth open or loudly. And even to this day, I try to still remember that. I just think it's a nice way to be, obviously for yourself and of course for others nearby. Okay, what else? I made my little notes here. We talked about the starving kids in China. Talked about mom would sit, but she didn't eat. So that was us growing up. Our main meal. Here's something odd. Well, to me it's odd, maybe not to you, but we didn't eat our food in order. We just ate whatever we wanted to eat. I did not notice this. It took me many, many years after my husband and I were married. He does it, his sister does it, his whole family, everybody from Indiana must do it. They eat their food in order. I didn't know that, even though I'd been married to him for years. And when he would say, "Oh, no, I have to have some more of this," or "I have to have some more of that," I didn't know that he was timing his plate so that he would have just enough bites. And his sister is the same way. And I'm telling you, I never paid attention, never noticed, because I don't pay attention to other people eating that closely. But then, when I did notice it, it really became something that I did not understand for anything, because I kept asking him, "So, like, what if you're out somewhere and you don't have enough items?" And he just wouldn't address it. All our family did as kids, we would save the best food for last. Now that I remember. But not having to eat everything, your drink included. And my husband had a salad. And how, that's just too stressful to sit down and time out your food. I'm sorry. You have to have a break in life. And when I noticed, then I could see as he was eating, he was planning every bite and sizing up. And I don't mean to be mean, but all that planning while you're eating, I honestly, is too stressful for me. Jello cups are way better than I ever thought they'd be. Jello in forever. Another reminder. If you enjoyed this video, to please push the thumbs up like button in hopes that the more likes YouTube sees on my channel, the more views I get. That'd be wonderful. That'd be marvelous. I appreciate your help with that. And as always,